First part of this guide will guide you through the process of adding two-factor authentication to your Raspberry Pi or any other Linux-based system. And the second part will add some security to your Raspberry Pi with a tool called Fail2Ban. Also, this video is part of a mini-series on how to easily set up fully functioning Foundry VTT on your Raspberry Pi. Welcome! Hi there, it's Wee from Helping Ninja. I'd like to show you step by step how to secure your Raspberry Pi with two-factor authentication. Let's get into it.
Let me just quickly update our package list. Okay, so for starters, we need to install 2FA package we'll be using. Sudo apt install libpm google authenticator. We'll face a few questions during the installation process. First one is, do you want authentication tokens to be time-based? Yes, we do. Press Y and hit enter. Bam! Now you see your code and QR code, which you need to scan by 2FA mobile application. There's a bunch of mobile applications that you can use for this. Just pick one you like and trust the most. Me personally, I use this 2FA app by LastPass. It's named simply Authenticator, but you can use apps created by Microsoft or Google. Okay. Scan this QR code with 2FA mobile application of your choosing and write the code generated by a mobile application into the command prompt in your terminal. For me, it was 852029. If you're getting any ideas, no, I won't be using this particular code. Now we see our emergency scratch codes. Put them somewhere secret, somewhere safe. They will save your butt if your phone gets lost or damaged. I repeat, save them somewhere safe, where you can find it later, if and when needed. Do I want to update Google Authenticator file? Yes, I do. Do I want to disallow multiple uses of the same authentication token? Yes, I do. Next question is pretty long and self-explanatory. Basically, if you have time synchronization issues, choose yes. If you don't, just put in no like me. Next question is about protecting your Raspberry Pi login against brute force attacks. Yes, we want to enable rate limiting. And that are all of the questions. Clear commands to clear the screen. What do we do next? Now we need to set up a few things. Edit this file, /etc/pamd/sshd. PAM is short for pluggable authentication modules. Scroll to the bottom of the file and add this line. Auth required PAM Google Authenticator.so. Save the file and exit. Next thing is to configure SSH daemon. Sudo vim /etc/sshdconfig. Find the line named challenge response authentication and set it to yes. Again, save the file and exit. Well, I forgot to do one more thing. Again, open the /etc/pamd/sshd file. Here we need to disable standard Unix authentication. We do that simply by commenting on this line, include common auth, save the file and exit. Also, we need to tell to SSH that we will be using for authentication our SSH keys and we will be putting in codes from 2FA mobile application with our keyboard. So once again, sorry about that, sudo vim /etc/sshd/config and add to the end of the file this authentication methods public key keyboard interactive. Save and exit. Restart SSH daemon so the changes to take effect. Sudo systemctl restart sshd. And let us check the behavior now with new SSH connection. Load our connection info, check if the SSH key is set and hit open. Nice. You see the first line I'm logging in as Pi user, authenticating with SSH key and I'm prompted for the code from the 2FA mobile app. I'll open my app, enter the code from app in Pi's terminal. You won't actually see me doing that because it's hidden. I'll hit enter at the end and voila, I'm logged in. So our login procedure consists of SSH key safely stored in our computer and the time-based verification code from our mobile app. Cool, right? I'd say that's pretty safe for our home lab Raspberry Pi. Okay, moving on. I'd like to show you one more tool which you can use to protect your Raspberry Pi. It's called Fail2Ban. It has many uses, but we will use it to add one more security layer to our SSH. Basically, what we want to do, we will ban attacker's IP address if he tries a few times to penetrate our defenses, making his goal as time-consuming and tedious endeavor as we can. But actually, this one is a simple one. Sudo apt install fail2ban. Now we have to create our configuration file. We'll set up the basics by copying a default configuration file and edit that one. So sudo cp as copy etc fail2ban slash jail.conf to etc fail2ban jail.local and edit the jail.local file. Find a section which is called SSH in brackets and follow my lead. Set enabled to true, filter SSHD, port SSH, ban action, IP tables dash multiport. This actually handles IP tables to block attacker's IP address. Ban time. Here you can set for how long you want to ban this IP address. I'll put 60 minutes or 1 hour. You can put here whatever you like. Max retry. This is how many attempts user or attacker has before he gets banned. Just think how many attempts you need to write the correct password or verification code. I'll put in 3. Hope it will be enough for me. Or I'll need to wait an hour before I get unbanned. Oh, I missed this one. That's a duplicit line now. I'll delete that. And that's all of the configuration you need to do. Save and close the file, restart fail2ban service, and we are good to go. Easy, right?
So, that's two-factor authentication with fail2ban as a bonus. Hope it helped, thanks for watching. If you feel a little bit safer about your Pi now, please do subscribe to my channel. See ya!